Hello students, welcome to today's class. Today we are going to start a new chapter, and that is chemical reactions. Okay, so what is chemical reaction? About that you already know. Chemical reaction is such a process where few substance, one or more substances react together to form a different entirely new substance, entirely different substance or substances. Okay, so chemical reactions. Chemical reactions. This is the name of the chapter. So it's there in half yearly syllabus. So here reactants react together. It may be reactant or reactants. They react together to form products. Okay, so this during this chemical reaction, the reactants which are there, which are involved in the chemical reaction, they are entirely change themselves. The rearrangement, actually chemical reaction is the rearrangement of the molecules, rearrangement of the atoms. So if we take an example, suppose methane CH4, okay, methane reacts with oxygen. This is a kind of hydrocarbon. What is hydrocarbon? Hydrocarbon are those substances which contain carbon and hydrogen. That's why the name hydrocarbon is there. Okay, so CH4, the structure of methane is like this. There is a central carbon atom. Along with that, four hydrogen atoms are there, which are arranged in this manner. Okay, this is a tetrahedral structure. So in simplified manner, I have written this. And oxygen, you know, there is a double bond between two oxygen atoms. So this is the structure of the reactants. This is methane and this is oxygen. Methane and this is, you know, oxygen in gaseous form. Okay. Now, when these two reacts together, the product will be carbon dioxide and water vapor. So all the hydrocarbons, when they react with oxygen, atmospheric oxygen or oxygen, if we supply oxygen, so whatever oxygen we are supplying, the hydrocarbons get combined together, get combined with the oxygen, and it will produce carbon dioxide along with water, H2O. Okay, CO2 plus H2O. Now, what will be the structure of carbon dioxide? We know that carbon is the central atom here, which is bonded with this, with two oxygen atoms. Okay. And water, oxygen is the central atom, and two hydrogens are there in this manner. Now, you can easily understand that in the product side, we are getting the bond between carbon and oxygen, and here oxygen and hydrogen bonds we are getting. Okay, whereas in reactant side, we are having bond of carbon and hydrogen, the bond between carbon and hydrogen, and the bonds between oxygen. So if we don't break the bond between carbon and hydrogen, we cannot get the carbon cannot form bond with oxygen. So for that, we must break the bonds. These bonds must be broken before forming the product. Okay, all the bonds we have to break. So what are the bonds? What do you mean by the bonds? These are called chemical bonds. Chemical bond is nothing, just
it's a attractive force act together, attractive force between two atoms, okay, which will keep them together. So this bonds has to be broken before forming the product.
This is called rearrangement. Okay, this we will be calling as rearrangement. See this, now all single atoms we are having, carbon, hydrogen, oxygens, all are single, all are separated. Now they can combine with any one
of the atom, any of the atom. So two hydrogen will get combined with oxygen, and this carbon will get combined with the oxygen. Okay, so this reaction is not balanced. So whatever number of oxygen and hydrogen we need, so after breaking the bonds, all the carbon and hydrogens are getting separated. The same manner we are getting separated the oxygen atoms. Now we are getting single oxygen atoms which can bond to with any one of the atom. Okay, now to form carbon dioxide, the carbon will get attached with oxygen. One carbon will get attached with two oxygens, and to form the water molecule, two hydrogens will get attached with one oxygen. So in this manner, rearrangement of the bonds will be there. This reaction is not balanced. So let us balance it. Yeah, four hydrogens are there. So if we write to this side, okay, so hydrogen is balanced. Now two oxygen is there, this side two oxygen, so total four oxygens we need, so 2O2. Okay, so two oxygen molecule we need, and to get complete combustion of methane. Okay, so this will be the reaction between methane and oxygen, and this is the rearrangement of the bonds. So in all the chemical reactions we are going to see this only. The first of all, the bonds will break to get the single or separated atoms, and then to form the new bond, to form the new substances, new molecules, the atoms, the separated atoms will rearrange themselves. They will again form, they will make new bonds together, and then they will be producing the product, they will be forming the new substance products. Okay, so in all the chemical reactions we are going to see this. Now so what are the characteristics of chemical reactions? One more example is also there. So let us discuss that first. The reaction between acid and base. Whenever we will be getting the reaction between acid and base, we are going to get the product as salt and water. Okay, so if we take the acid, suppose hydrogen chloride, hydrochloric acid if we take, and base suppose we are taking as sodium hydroxide, NaOH. Okay, sodium hydroxide is the base. So what will be the salt? The sodium will get attached with chlorine, so NaCl along with water, H2O. Okay, so easily you can see that the bond between hydrogen and chlorine, that will break. The bond between sodium and hydroxyl group, that will break. And then after rearranging the molecules, the particles or the atoms, they will rearrange themselves, and then the sodium will get attached with chlorine, and hydrogen will get attached with oxygen, and we will be getting the salt as sodium chloride and the water. Okay, so in each and every chemical reactions, we are going to see the breaking of bond first and then the making of new bonds. Now let us discuss the characteristics. What are the characteristics of chemical reaction? So that we are going to discuss now. So first of all, in chemical reactions, we are going to get so many changes, so many visible changes we will see. So the first one is, characteristics of chemical reaction. So first of all, evolution of gas. So during the chemical reactions, we can see evolution of gas, the production or the gas will be produced. So that easily we can understand from this bubbles. When the gas will form in the solution, we will be getting the bubbles of the gas. Okay, in bubble manner, the gas will be, as the gas is trapped there, as the gas is trapped in the solution, so when the gas will come out, it will be forming the bubbles. Okay, and this is called the effervescence. So already we have I have shown you one gas production of or a chemical reaction where we have seen the evolution of gas, that is the production of hydrogen gas. Okay, so let us discuss that first. How we have produced hydrogen, we have taken zinc granules we have taken, and in this we had added dilute H2SO4, dilute sulfuric acid. So what will be the, these are the reactants, what will be the product? We are getting zinc sulfate, we will be getting zinc sulfate, and along with this hydrogen gas. So as hydrogen is a gas, so it is light in weight, so it will evolve. That's why I have given this upward arrow. So this already you have learned that how we can make the chemical equations more informative. So this is one of that. So by this, in this indicates that this is in gaseous state. This substance, this element, this substance is in gaseous state. So this is hydrogen gas. Now if we take baking soda, that is sodium bicarbonate, NaHCO3, sodium bicarbonate. So in this, if we add any acid, it may be vinegar, that is acetic acid we can use here, or if we add dilute sulfuric acid, that also will work, or if we add hydrochloric acid, that also work. So if we, let us add dilute HCl in this hydrochloric acid, then this as soon as we will be adding this water, adding this dilute hydrochloric acid, this acid in dry sodium bicarbonate in baking soda, we will be seeing the effervescence of carbon dioxide. So here what we are going to get, sodium chloride, this is the salt, okay, along with carbon dioxide plus water. So this carbon dioxide as effervescence, we will be getting so many bubbles in that, or especially this reaction, how we do, we take in a test tube. This I will be showing you afterwards. So first of all, we take dilute hydrochloric acid in a test tube. Okay,
See, suppose this is the test tube. Here we are. We have to take the solution. This is dilute hydrochloric acid. Okay. And in this, slowly we will be adding this sodium bicarbonate. This is solid. Okay. Sodium bicarbonate in solid form. Okay. So that the powder, the dust that we will be sprinkle on this in this hydrochloric acid. Then here, after adding this, we will be getting the bubbles. Okay, so in this manner we will be getting the bubbles, and this is called effervescence. Next, other than this two, actually many reactions are there during the production of oxygen gas. How we will be producing, how we will produce oxygen gas, for that we need to take potassium chlorate, KClO3. Okay, this is potassium chlorate. So we need to heat this. We need to heat potassium chlorate to a high temperature, then it will break to form, it will decompose to form potassium chloride, KCl, along with oxygen gas. So this is also in gaseous form, so we need to give this upward arrow here. Okay, now this potassium chlorate, this break this or to decompose this, we need a high temperature. Okay, here we apply a much temperature there. Okay, like 600 to 650 or like that temperature we need to use here. Okay, but to produce this much of temperature in laboratory, that is not so easy. Okay, it may break the substance, it may break the apparatus and all. It can cause harm to the whoever will be doing the experiment, will be carrying out the experiment. It may harm the that person. Okay, so many drawback is there to use this temperature. So what we are going to do here, we will be using a catalyst. Okay, catalyst, you know, these are the substances, catalysts. Catalysts are the substances which will not change themselves, but during the chemical reaction, but if we use those substances, they will be increasing the rate of the reaction. Okay, easily then we can get the product. So catalysts are the substances which will not change themselves, which will remain as it is before and after the reaction. But using those substances, we can easily perform the reaction. We can easily get the required product. Okay, here in this reaction, particular reaction, for different reactions, we have a fixed or particular catalyst. Okay, so in this case, during the production of oxygen from potassium chlorate, we need to use manganese dioxide, that is MnO2. Manganese dioxide, this will act as catalyst here. Okay, this catalyst we are using here. Okay, and if we use this, then within 180 to 200 degree centigrade only, we can perform the reaction. See, using this catalyst, the temperature has been reduced to 200 degree centigrade, from 600 or 650 to 200 degree centigrade we have got. So using this catalyst, this is this will be helpful for us, and that's why we are using this. And you will see the catalyst, as it will not change itself, that's why always we will be using this third bracket to
express or to whenever we will be writing the catalyst, we are going to use this.
Okay, we will be writing in this manner. This indicates that the catalyst will remain as it is before and after the chemical reaction. Okay, so here we had oxygen, okay, in this reaction. Next, if we add another reaction of producing sulfur dioxide, for that we need sodium sulfite, okay, Na2SO3. This is sodium sulfite, Na2SO3. Okay,
sodium sulfate is Na2SO4. This is sodium sulfite. Okay, T is there.
Sodium sulfite. Okay, so here if we add dilute hydrochloric acid HCl or any acid, if we add here, then we are going to get sodium chloride plus sulfur dioxide SO2 plus water. Okay, this again in the form of effervescence in as we have got carbon dioxide, in the same manner the effervescence of sulfur dioxide we are going to get, and sulfur dioxide having a strong smell of a characteristic smell of sulfur, burnt sulfur. Okay, so from that we can, from this particular smell, we can distinguish that the sulfur dioxide gas. So these are some of the reactions where we got the evolution of gas during the chemical reactions. Many more are there, so all we cannot do in this manner. So just this four we have discussed. Okay, so here I'm ending our today's class. You just revise this, and as in the live class I have already discussed about that syllabus and all, so you, once you go through that, you be sure about it, and whatever doubts you have, you just see that, and in the next class again I will be there, so there you can ask your queries and all. Okay, so this is all for today. Thank you.